Hello, everyone. My name is Chris Castro, and I am the owner of Shift Inc. I've been doing a kind of off-the-cuff teaching series on things that I'm reading from the Bible. I'm just finishing up the book of Hebrews, and today I want to talk about trusting. As a human being, trust is something we generally have to learn to have. In uncertain search situations, oftentimes we insist that people earn our trust. With God, we're supposed to trust. If you claim to be a believer of Jesus, you're supposed to just trust him, even if it doesn't make sense. And when I was reading through Hebrews 11, so many verses popped, and I'm just going to go through them really quickly and just kind of call them out. And I'm not going to read whole verses. I'm really just going to read snippets of verses. So here they are. Hebrews 11, and the first one is verse 6, and without trusting, it is impossible to be well-pleasing to God, because whoever approaches him must trust that he does exist. And that he does become a rewarder to those who seek him out. Moving down to verse 8, it says he went out without knowing where he was going, and that's referring to Abraham. Going down a little bit more, verse 11, he regarded the one who had made the promise as trustworthy, and that was about believing that Isaac was going to be born, even though Isaac wasn't at that point, and they were really old and weren't supposed to be able to have kids. Moving down to 13, all these people kept trusting until they died without receiving what had been promised. And if you read all the verses before, it'll notate all of the people that he's talking about, which were basically the bigwigs in the Old Testament. If you go to near the end of chapter 11, there's a verse 27 where it says he persevered as one who sees the unseen. It's talking about Moses. And then all the way at the end in verse 36, it says others underwent the trials of being mocked and whipped, then chained and imprisoned. They were stoned, sawed in two, murdered by the sword. They went about clothed in sheepskins and goatskins, destitute, persecuted, mistreated, wandering about in deserts and mountains, living in caves and holes in the ground. The world was not worthy of them. All of these had their merit attest because of their trusting. Hebrews 11 is basically the go-to verse when you're in a really difficult time and having a hard time trusting God and his faithfulness. And I want to encourage you right now that God is faithful. He is faithful to everyone who puts their trust in him. Whatever situation you're in now, no matter how traumatic, how difficult, how painful, I've been in a number of those situations. He is trustworthy, and I really feel led to remind you of that. And so, as you are moving on with your day, just take a second, go to a quiet place and close your eyes, even if this is the first time you are ever talking to God. Just close your eyes and say, Lord, or God, if he's not your Lord yet, I want to trust you. Help me trust you. And I promise he will meet you wherever you need to be met to begin that trust journey. And as you lean in and you trust him more and more, lots of amazing things are going to happen. So thanks for listening. I love to help people in uncertain situations kind of walk through those journeys. So if you are interested in talking to me a little bit about how we can partner to do that, just go to my website. There's a coffee icon on the bottom for a coffee and conversation. Just go ahead and click on that. There's a short little video and then register for it. It's free. And I would love to have an opportunity to talk to you. Have a great day and enjoy everything that the Lord is doing in your life, because nothing is wasted. Everything transforms you in some way, shape, or form. Take care. Bye-bye.